This freaky motorcycle you're looking at right here has turned out to be one of the most exciting machines to come out of the Indian automobile industry in 2019. Now, what makes it so exciting is that this is India's first electric sports bike, but also the fact that it's been entirely designed and developed right here in India, in fact, just down the road there in Bengaluru. This is the Ultraviolette F77, and we've been given a very brief amount of time to ride it here at the MMRT. So without any further ado, let's get to it.
And we'll begin with the backstory. Ultraviolette is a Bengaluru-based startup that's been working on the concept of an electric motorcycle all the way since 2015. Things have moved on a lot since then, and TVS now holds a 25% stake in the company. The F77 is Ultraviolette's first product, and when you're trying to introduce something that's completely new and unheard of, it helps if your bike is built to stand out.
Alright, so what do you say about this design? Well, one thing I can say for sure is that you've seen nothing like this out there. The F77 wears a unique and aggressive set of proportions with an interesting combination of a full fairing and an individual headlight up front. What I will say is that when you look at it up close, you'll see that quality levels seem to be really high and there has been a lot of attention paid to the details.
This is one unique and sporty looking motorcycle, and that's because the proportions are very unusual. The side profile looks quite mass heavy with a full fairing, and this is offset by an individual naked bike style headlamp. There is no wind protection, but the suspension shrouds around the upside-down fork help to create a muscular look. The tail section is perhaps the most conventional angle, with a sharp and attractive set of lines that look like they came straight off a sports bike. There's full LED lighting all around, and the lamps at both ends look sporty and detailed. Ultraviolette plans to offer the bike in three color schemes, and there will be some interesting accessories on offer as well. Ultimately, the F77 certainly doesn't wear a classically pretty design, but it has heaps of presence and the bike commands plenty of attention in person. Quality seems to be a priority, and there are plenty of small details like the foot peg holders, the superbike-like swing arm, the TFT display, and those smartly designed wheels that suggest this will be a premium machine. The F77 then looks fast just standing still, but thankfully it packs some exciting performance numbers to match. This bike runs a frame-mounted, air-cooled electric motor that claims 33.5 horsepower and an absolutely massive 90 Nm of torque. Petrol or electric, those are some exciting looking numbers.
With so much horsepower and especially so much torque on offer, you'd expect a very high level of performance out on the racetrack. But the F77 tells a slightly different story, and this bike's performance is more in line with 200cc machines rather than the 300cc competition that you would associate it with going by the spec sheet.
Ultraviolette claims a 7.5 second run from 0 to 100 kph, and the initial acceleration surge certainly feels like the bike is capable of that. The strong pull begins to taper past 80 kph, but the bike will still get up to about 120 without a struggle. Ultraviolette claims a top speed of 147 kph, but I suspect this will take some distance to achieve. Time was scarce, so I only got to set one fast lap on the track, where the bike managed to set an indicated top speed of just under 135. This puts the F77's performance more in line with 200 to low-end 250cc machines rather than the 300cc competition. The motor powers the rear wheel via chain drive, and there is no clutch or changing gears to bother with. Just twist the throttle and go. The good news is that the throttle response is very smooth and natural feeling, which makes the bike easy and unintimidating to ride. As for sound, there's an interesting whine from the motor and the reduction ratio gears. But when a bike makes so little noise, you tend to hear everything else much more clearly. That's when you'll realize that the F77's chain drive can be quite loud, and I think a quiet running belt drive would have been nicer, even though it would have been more expensive and perhaps not as easy to keep maintained at the average roadside mechanic. We had about just 20 minutes with the bike in total, but in that time, two things became clear. The first is that the initial acceleration rush is strong and uninterrupted, and I'm sure that this will be great fun to exploit out on the street. The second is that this is a very sharp handling motorcycle when it comes time to attack some corners.
Ultraviolette has developed their own bespoke trellis frame for this motorcycle, and it packs some pretty aggressive steering geometry numbers. Now, with bars this wide, it's no surprise that this is a very fast steering motorcycle, and it is quite exciting to ride.
With a relatively short wheelbase and an aggressive steering rake angle, the F77 reacts rapidly to rider inputs. You need to be measured with your movements because the F77 responds as fast, if not faster than a KTM RC390. And it'll be interesting to see how this fares in the real world with all of its mid-corner bumps, craters and cows. Thanks to a sharp front brake, an impressively low curb weight and no cattle in sight, the F77 loved attacking corners on the racetrack. When pushed hard though, you can tell that the rear suspension felt a little too soft, and that's where the expensive Metzeler M7RR tyres earned their keep. Although it should be said that even something like the Metzeler M5 would have been more than enough at this performance level. Ultimately, the F77 feels a little bit on edge when you push it to the limit, but Ultraviolette tells us that they're working on fine-tuning the suspension setup. Things may stand to improve, but for now, it's clear that this is a fun, sharp and responsive machine. Of course, most F77s will not spend their life ridden to the limit at the racetrack, and this bike has a lot more to offer, especially when it comes to technology and gadgets.
Now, the exciting thing about futuristic electric vehicles like this is that they can innovate in ways that you haven't imagined. Now, this bike has a lot of technology and features packed into it, which we'll get into in a moment. But for now, this is my favorite one. That's your battery packs right down there.
Ultraviolette has cleverly split the battery into three individual packs, each weighing 8.6 kilos. This allows you to remove one or two if you need to charge them externally without the risk of pulling a hernia. The packs work together in parallel, and the company recommends running all three or at least two at all times. Charging takes 5 hours with a standard charger and 1.5 hours with an optional fast charger. There's also going to be an optional portable power bank style charger that can be carried around in a backpack. Ultraviolette claims groundbreaking energy density levels from their in-house battery pack design, and this allows them to claim real-world range figures of 130 to 150 kilometers despite a relatively modest total battery capacity of 4.2 kilowatt-hours. Of course, we will have to put this to the test, and we also can't comment on the moment on how performance will fare once the charge level drops. But for now, let's talk about all the technology packed within this motorcycle. The F77 uses a 4G SIM as well as a 9-axis inertial measurement unit, which is similar to what you'll find in a smartphone. This combination unlocks multiple connected features, and there is a whole host of functionality available within the TFT display as well. The bike has 3 riding modes and it comes with adjustable regenerative braking. There isn't any form of traction control, but safety does come via a dual channel ABS. While all that sounds good, we unfortunately didn't get to experience any of it. As it turns out, the bikes we rode weren't as production ready as we thought. The TFT display was a mock-up with a smartphone running underneath, and the switchgear wasn't in final spec as well, which meant we couldn't control any of the electronic features, including the regen braking or the riding modes. In case you're wondering, the bikes were set to offer full power when we rode them. So how much will all this cost you? Ultraviolette says that the F77 will be priced between ₹3 and 3.25 lakh on road when it goes on sale late next year in Bengaluru, with other cities to follow at a later date. At this price, you certainly aren't getting a similar price to performance ratio as a petrol powered machine. What you will be, however, is an early adopter, and early adopters of any technology have never had it cheap. As much as I wish we got to experience the production-ready motorcycles, for now, all I can say is that the F77 looks promising.
The F77 clearly is a motorcycle with a lot of promise, but here's the deal. The bikes we've ridden today are still very much in the pre-production prototype stage, and we didn't get to experience many of the features, and there are still things that Ultraviolette needs to iron out. The good news is that the company has been clear that they will not deliver any motorcycles for at least another year, starting in October 2020. So that gives them time to refine and iron out all the issues. For now, this is a motorcycle that I'm really intrigued by, but I would recommend that you wait until we ride the final production-ready versions of this bike to give you the final word.